Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Bhakti Yogena Manasi. Sisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, there is two procedure. One is ascending, another is descending procedure. Bhakti Yogena Manasi Pranihite Amale Apashat Purusham Purnam Mayancha Tadabhasrayam. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Gauriya Goshtipati Sisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, there is two procedure, one is ascending procedure, another is descending procedure, through which bonded soul can try to reach Supreme Lord. Actually, descending procedure means you will have to depend upon your own power. You think I have enough strength and power, money power, manpower, educational power, all I have, so I can try to know who is Supreme Lord. Another procedure is ascending procedure. Descending procedure and ascending procedure. Ascending procedure and descending procedure. So, the other procedure is that you will have to depend upon the mercy of Guru, Vaishnava and Bhagavan only. Only you will have to depend upon the mercy of Guru, Vaishnava and Bhagavan. O Supreme Lord, if you allow me to know who you are, how you are, then I can know something. Otherwise, not possible. Otherwise, it is not at all possible for me to know who you are, how you are. That is the big problem. So, actually, those who are depending on the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, somehow, someday can go up and up, and ultimately they can understand what is their ultimate objective, how to do bhajan, what is the ultimate objective I will have to attain. Because without any objective, without any goal, incentive, there is no even one mad who want to do anything. So everybody want to understand first, I am going to put my energy, I am going to do this and that. So what is the ultimate result? That is called prayantatta. Ultimately, what I am going to get, so that you are engaging me in bhajan, I am doing so much effort, I am putting so much energy, what I am going to get, I must know first. If I cannot know, if I cannot understand, what is the objective I am going to get? Then I cannot do proper bhajan. That is called prayojan tattva, vigyan. You can remember in 10th canto, we can find Brahma also tried to play his forehead. Four heads, you know. Brahma having four heads. Brahma wanted to play forehead to understand who is Supreme Lord. But ultimately, he was fed up, he was bound to surrender unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord, and he was bound to speak, out of my own effort, I tried my best, but it's not possible, I cannot know. So there, Brahma speaking, though I am trying my best to go and up, I can go up and I can try to understand you. But that is not possible for me. I am totally failure. That's why Gani prayasa mudapasa namanti epa jivanti sanmukaritam bhavadiya vartam sthanet sthanesthita sutigatam tonubhang manuvir jeprasa ajito jito piyosi tvaistrilokhyam. Hey Prabhu, now onward I can never try to believe or depend upon my own energy and power. From today onward, I am totally failure. So, I wanted to play my gyan, brain, but I am totally failure. So, Brahma speaking, gyane prayasam udapasyam. Udapasyam means the effort. I never, from today onward, I can never try to play my brain to understand you. So, all my material knowledge I can throw. Udapasamane for long away, distant, out of my reach, I like to throw. So the neighbor, I can try to take the help of my jnana. So I can never try. Jnane prayasam udapasya namanti eva. I can pray dandavat to you. Always pray dandavat. Nama, this word, you know the meaning of nama? You know the meaning of nama? Nama means this naman. But this no means no. Ma means your false ego, you are going to throw and become humble. That is called the meaning of nama. Nama, you know? Namaha. This nama, this word means no means nishedatrak. Nishedatmak means no. You should not express false ego, you can throw, no. Ma mean ahankar, you can throw. That is called nama. And nama is only possible by kaya man bhakya, body, speech and mind. Suppose you are going to pay dandavat to any Guru Vaishnav. You are only speaking, vancha kalpatarvasya kipasindibhavajipatitanam pavan. But that is not dham, nama. You will have to pay dandavat, prostrated, body, speech, bancha kalpaturvascha, kipasindibhavacha, and mental, mind. Mind also you will have to throw as Puspanjali unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava. Then and only then, your naman, this procedure, pranam, naman, dandavad is successful. Otherwise you cannot get the result properly. So this way actually, Brahma wanted to throw out all his personal effort to know Supreme Lord. Now, growing humble attitude inside, and gyane prayasam udapasya namanti eva. After that, if you try to pay dandavat to Supreme Lord, you can try, but in bonded condition, many times I told, the bonded soul, they cannot get in touch with Supreme Lord, not possible. In bonded condition, bonded soul, they cannot get in touch with Supreme Lord. You can go to different pilgrimage, pay dandavat to Jagannath, this, that. You can try. But actually, you cannot get in connection with Supreme Lord. You will have to take help of an agent. Agent, you know? You will have to take help of an agent. You will have to take help of one agent. Agent means Guru Vaishnav. Guru Vaishnav, many I already told, Guru Vaishnav is a transparent media. Guru Vaishnav is the transparent media. Guru Vaishnav is the transcendental media through which you can see what is what pertaining to that aprakita jagat, transcendental world. If you try yourself to watch what is dham, navadip dham, if you can try to watch what is Vrindavan Dham, only you can see some garbage there. You cannot see Dham. Dham is not a matter of joke. Transcendental abode of Supreme Lord is not a matter of joke. So, I can give you one reminder that through Chatusarki Bhagavatam, Bhagavan Sri Krishna going to give total idea, Dibhva Gyan, because Brahma was initiated by Krishna. Kam Gayatri Kam Bij was given. So after initiation, Brahma wanted to rectify his brain. I mean, initiation is perfect. Material brain is always rectified. If Diksha is a so-called procedure, then you are not going to get result. So this way, the case of Brahma, we want to consider here. So Brahma want to take help of Harikatha and Kirtan from Guru Vaishnav. Harikatha and Kirtan from Vaishnav. Sthane sthitaha sutigatam tonubang manovhir. Sthane sthitaha sutigatam tonubang manovhir mean, sthane sthitaha, it means sadugan sakase sthitaha, sakase. I want to stay in front of Sadguru Vaishnav and I want to hear continuously sthane sthitaha sutigatam tonubang manovhir. Tonubang manovhir mean, Kaya Manovakya, body, speech and mind, I like to surrender unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan and I like to stay in front of them and I want to hear Harikatha from them continuously. Because that is the main advantage. That is the main advantage we can get in front of Guru Vaishnava, because Vaishnava Sangeta Mon Anandita Anukhyan Sada Hai Krishna Parasango. You hear? No? Why you don't hear? Vaishnava Sangeta Mon Anandita Anukhyan Sada Hai Krishna Parasango. In Kirtan we get. Vaishnava Sango and Guru Vaishnava Sango mean Vaishnava Sangeta Mon Anandita Anukhyan. I can get transcendental enjoyment. Always I can enjoy. Aprakita Ananda. Why? But sada, on continuously, we can get the topics of Krishna from them. They are not speaking anything material. So I can get that kind of chance so that I can go up and up, because I cannot make any connection with that aprakita jagat, transcendental world. There is a single and unique procedure, that aprakita sabda brahma. If you can take the help of aprakita sabda brahma, then you can get in connection with Supreme Lord someday. You go on hearing aprakita sabda brahma, because without aprakita sabda brahma, you cannot get in connection with that Supreme Lord. You have to take the help of aprakita sabda brahma. So Brahma, speaking this way, so sthane sthita sutigatam tonubang matu manovhir, so usually we know you are ajito. What do you mean by ajito? First kirtan, meaning you will have to go through kirtan. It is my strict instruction to you. Otherwise you don't hear Harikatha. You have to go through kirtan, all meaning very catchy way expressed in kirtan by Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Narottama Thakur. If you don't do kirtan, you cannot digest. Very shortly, I can try to get some, find out some time when I can go on, you know, explaining one by one kirtan. Follow? Through kirtan, you can get Supreme Lord. So only through kirtan, everything you can get. So, Vaishnava Sangeta Mon Anandita Anukhyan. Why all devotees, though you are Nitya Siddha, those who are sadhana siddha, those are all elevated. They always want to pray in front of Supreme Lord, O Prabhu, give me the association of Guru Vishnu. Why? They are already elevated. But elevated, okay. If you go up to that transcendental world, there also you need satsanga, sadhu sangha. There also, not here only. There also you are going to always get satsanga, always, all the time. So, Vaishnava Sangha, you want to pray to Supreme Lord to get the association of Sadguru Vaishnava Sangha, then I can enjoy, transcendental enjoyment I can get. And because they always speaking the topics of Krishna. They always continuously speaking about the topics of Krishna. They are speaking not nothing material. So Guru Vaishnava Sangha is vital because Harikatha Harikirtan I can hear and through which I can cut material bondage and go up and up. So in Shastra we hear, or very often we have the chance to hear, you are Ajit. Ajit mean? What do you mean by Ajit? What do you mean by Ajit? Ajit means this Sanskrit word, and Bengali also we say Ajit. Ajit means who can never be conquered. Who can never be conquered. You cannot fight with Supreme Lord, you cannot, you know, you cannot come out successful. All your brain power, money power, everything, manpower, all if you can put, but still you cannot come out successful. That's why it's called Ajita. Ajita means who can never be conquered. At the same time, we have some positive bhava, because sometimes we find that you are speaking, O Supreme Lord, you are Ajit, we know. But sometimes we hear from Bhagavatam that you are totally controlled by Guru Vaishnava. We find in Shastra also, though we find Ajita, your name is Ajit, but still we find so many documents in scripture and Bhagavatam, Puran, everywhere, that you are always controlled by Guru Vaishnava. He asatantra ivadijo. You know, you are always controlled by Guru Vaishnava. So what is the solution? That I can find out next day. So now today, we are going to speak about Jiva Tattva a little bit, and we'll have to find out the case, we have to point out the case of Brahma, Sankar, because Brahma is Jivakati. Jivakati, you know? Vibhinamsha and, you know, Svamsha I can discuss today. And, you know, this is the point. So Ajita means you can never be conquered by anybody. That's why your name is Ajita. But still, Brahma speaking, though your name is Ajita, but still you can be conquered by devotion, love. Pure love and devotion, you can be conquered. And those devotees, they can get control over you. Very easy. Follow? So, in 8th canto here, there are so many documents here, that Supreme Lord speaking, I am not Shatantra. I am not. So, he Ashatantra Iva Dijo. I am always controlled by Guru Vaishnava. And at the same time, it is called Ajit. Anyway, so now, Brahma, Sankar, they are also hypnotized by the Maya of Supreme Lord. The sloka I started with is the first canto, Bhakti Yogena Manasi Parnihite Amale. Bhakti Yogena Manasi Parnihite Amale. Apasyat purusham purunam mayancha tadapasrayam. Jaya sanmihitam jivaha. This sloka. Here, this sloka we find that Vyasadeva Goswami is very anxious because Vyasadeva Goswami not getting total satisfaction. Vyasadeva Goswami jo writing Mahabharata, Puran, everything. But still today, Vyasadeva Goswami not getting any satisfaction, full satisfaction. There's some sort of dissatisfaction touching heart. Why? He want to know the reason for why. No saturation is still there inside my heart. So, Vyasadeva Goswami is sitting in Samapras Ashram. Samapras Ashram is there in Bodhrika Ashram. I've been there two times minimum. I went there. And that was Himalaya topmost place. There is one cave, Gufa. Inside that Gufa, Vasudev Goswami doing bhajan, also Saraswati Nodi falling down. I wanted to touch Saraswati, but all some devotees of pilgrimage, they say, Maharaj, don't go, you can fall down. Sir, I was trying my heart to go and touch the water. But no, Maharaj, don't touch. From up you can pay, because you cannot control. And there is very force, hill, you can go, bro. Still, I tried my best. Anyway, that was the source of Saraswati Nadi there. Very nice. Very nice. And from there, actually, 7-10 kilometers you will have to go. There's Sahasadhara, one place. There's a China border almost, Tibet. Anyway, there, so that Sammaprasa, that is called Sammapras Ashram. In that ashram, Vasudev meditating, trying to do, you know, think about the reason for why I am not totally satisfied, no saturated. Why saturation not kind? In the meantime, you know, Naraji Maharaj coming. I am not going to speak in details. So Naraji Maharaj coming and asking some question to Satyavati Tanai. Tanai means son of Satyavati, Suto, Vasudev Goswami, why it looks that you are not satisfied? That's why Brahma, actually Naraji Maharaj asking to Vasudev Goswami, Naraji Maharaj speaking, you already compiled Mahabharat, Puran, everything, all you have complied, Upanishad, Vedanta, everything. Why you looks not totally satisfied? Vasudev Goswami is saying, that is the reason. That is why I am thinking. That is why I am also thinking the reason for why I am not satisfied. You will have to give the answer, please. I don't know what is the reason. Vasudev Goswami is a Saktavesh avatar. Vasudev Goswami is a Saktavesh avatar. And Sukadev Goswami, Nandanandan Krishnastu, Sukaha. Sukadev Goswami, Nandanandan Krishnastu, Sukha. Sukadev Goswami is Krishna himself. Krishna coming in the form of Sukadev Goswami. Nandanandan Krishnastu, Nandanandan Krishnastu, Sukaha Swayam, Sukadev Goswami. And Vasudev Goswami is Saktavesh avatar. I can come to this point. Vasudev Goswami, Saktavesh avatar, Vasudev Goswami compiling everything, but still not feeling any saturation. Saturation point is not still there. Then Naraji Maharaj asking some question first. Why it looks that you are not satisfied with your body and mind? We usually meet with each other and speaking, how you are? We are speaking. But here, Naraji Maharaj speaking, Manaso Sarido Ebaba. Are you okay with your body and mind? But what is this question? Here I can come to this point, very important. Because Vasudev Goswami is not bonded soul, Vasudev Goswami is Saktavesh avatar. So for our kind information, to inform us that bonded soul always feeling some influence of his material body. Bonded soul always feeling some influence of his material body and mind. Cannot go out of that. Any stage. If bonded soul can go up, cut all material bondage, aprakita condition, then okay. Otherwise, cannot go out of the influence of Maya. Anyway, to teach us, Naraji Maharaj speaking, then when Vasudev Goswami asking, that is the question I wanted to put in front of you. So please, please advise me, what is the reason for why I am not satisfied totally? Then Naraji Maharaj speaking, though you have written so many things, but you are not going to give anything which is, you know, just Amrita for bonded soul. In Mahabharata, in Puran, you have written so many things. But those bonded souls, they are quite natural, they can feel attraction for matter. And you are going to, through Mahabharata, you have written, but those who are elevated, they can search out Mahabharata and find out the exact cream. That's why Prabhupada told, don't try to go through Mahabharata. You can get confusion. In each and every step, you can get confusion. You cannot understand why this case happening in Mahabharata. Why Draupadi going to marry five, you know, husband? She is chasty, topmost. Why Kunti Devi doing this way? That way, so many problems can come. You cannot understand. You can get confusion. So, Prabhupada speaking, you need not go through Mahabharata. Better you can go through, Bhakti-mukta speaking, you can go through Chaitanya Bhagavata daily. Daily we'll have to go through, it is the instruction of Bhakti-mukta Thakur. Daily we'll have to go through Chaitanya Bhagavata. If time is limited, still you will have to read at least 2 pages and understand. So what is your ultimate goal? You like to get Bhakti, that you can get. Chaitanya Bhagavata is more than enough to give you bhakti. So you will have to go to Bhakti-mukta Thakur speaking. Even at present, you will have to keep Chaitanya Charitamrita aside. Even now, it is my advice, you can keep Chaitanya Charitamrita aside and try to read. No, not throw. You can keep. But go on reading Chaitanya Bhagavat. Someday, that, you know, Guru Vaishnav can allow you that kind of power through which you can realize what is there written in Chaitanya Charitamrita. It is more than Bhagavatam. So typical, Chaitanya Charitamrita, so ambiguity, complicacy there, you cannot understand. So, top secret Siddhanta. So, those who can understand Srimad Bhagavat, they also cannot understand Chaitanya Charitamrita. What is the topmost Siddhanta, vichar, there already. So now, Naraji Maharaj saying, that is a general, you know, instinct, is a general attraction of the common people for matter. Matter, you know? For matter. Illusion there. So you already written this thing in different scriptural, but you are not going to do anything concrete through which a Jivatma can get Shuddha Bhakti, through which a Jivatma can get Shuddha Bhakti, you are not. So you will have to write all about Shuddha Bhakti and a Krishna Leela. You will have to write about Krishna Leela. You will have to write about Krishna Leela pure. Though in Mahabharata we can get some Krishna Leela. In Mahabharata we can get some Krishna Leela. Okay. In here, there, different scriptural we can get. But still, it is not sufficient. You will have to describe the transcendental Nectarian Lila Vilas. Nectarian Lila Vilas of Krishna in a big way. Follow. So that this Lila can put effect on bonded soul to make them free. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, that day, maybe 1 month before, I was speaking one point. That in Chaitanya Charitamrita, you find Rai Ramananda and Mahaprabhu discussing with each other. You can remember Rai Ramananda Sambad. You know the Rai Ramananda Sambad in Chaitanya Charitamrita. There actually, it is written that bonded soul naturally feeling some attraction for Maya, matter. But still, Bhagavan Sikhisno speaking, they are always praying for material enjoyment to me. Krishna speaking, they are foolish. They are always, praying to me to get some material objectives, but it is written there, Ei murkho ami biggo, ere bishoy keno dibo. Ei murkho, he is foolish. I am, Supreme Lord. Why I can give this material, enjoyment to him? It can be a reason of bondage in his life. So, maybe he is asking, but still, I can give the nectar of my lotus feet, and someday, today or tomorrow, he can forget material enjoyment. He can concentrate on a prakita, ananda, nectar. Follow. Prabhu kahe, he is going to worship me. At the same time, he is asking, expecting some material enjoyment for me. Prabhu kahe, ama bhaje, mange vishay shuk. Prabhu speaking, he is worshipping me, giving garland, giving puspanjali, okay. But still, expecting some material enjoyment for me. Prabhu kahe, ama bhaje, mange vishay shuk. Prabhu kahe, ama bhaje, mange vishay shuk. Prabhu kahe, ei murkho ami biggo. Ere vishay kene dibo. Sacharan amrita diya vishay bhulaibo. Sacharan amrita diya vishay bhulaibo. So I can give the nectar of my lotus feet, and today or tomorrow he can forget about material enjoyment. He can never expect anything. So you have to get material enjoyment. So this is the reason. Chaitanya Charitamrita we get. So bonded soul, Naradji Maharaj speaking, bonded soul, it is quite natural. They are feeling some attraction for material enjoyment. Even in Archan Paddhati, no? You have gone through Archan Paddhati? Never? Archan Paddhati, you can find there that devotee praying to Supreme Lord, I want to feel that kind of attraction which is quite natural in this material world. A man can feel attraction for woman can feel attraction for man. Oh Prabhu, I want to get that quite normal attraction for you. So nice example, you see. So it is written there, very nice example. Jo Jubati Nam, it is written in Sanskrit. You understand Sanskrit? By now? No? Jubati Nam Yatha Yuno. Junam Jubatu Yatha. As it is quite natural in Mazda. Young man is there, quite natural. Eyes going to that lady. Nobody is getting inspiration to look. Quite natural. Nobody giving is say you look at there. Quite natural. But if you can get that kind of, natural attraction for Supreme Lord, that was the case. I can speak someday with Ramanujajyo someday. I can speak the case. Bharati Maharaj very often used to speak the story. Story is not actually fact, actually. You always want to look at wife, so nice wife. Always, Bharati Maharaj used to speak. But someday, all devotees there actually become very angry and speaking to Gurudev. Ramanujajyo, okay, I can arrange. Then he is going to take that devotee into Ranganatham Mandir. And Ramanujajyo praying to Supreme Lord, oh Prabhu, he is idiot number one, foolish. If you can help him to change his taste, to look, material beauty, then is okay, it is my request. Then Ranganatham giving the darshan, so nice. He say, what is this? So nice, Vaikuntha appear by the request of Ramanujacharya. And he could see, what is this? So nice looking, Kundalin Karna, so nice. From then onward, he spit on material beauty. He never look at wife. Because today wife, okay, tomorrow become grandmother, cannot. We don't like to see. So one Siddha Mahatma, those who are elevated devotee, they never look any woman, any man, anything, anything. Their darshan is always big Vaikuntha darshan. Their darshan is always Vaikuntha darshan. Whenever they look at any man, they can see the Jivatma inside you. They are not going to see your body. At all they see body, they are going to see the ultimate result of this body. Follow what I mean, it's a very important point. Prabhupada always used to speak this thing. If you want to become brahmachari, if you want to become sannyasi, if you want to become ideal grihastha for them, especially for sannyasi and brahmachari, is special. That whenever you look here and there, you will have to think the final result of that object. Parinam. Parinam, you know, in Sanskrit is the parinam. What is the result? What is the result? I am bound to speak this way. Don't take it otherwise. Yesterday, over telephone, I was speaking Harikatha. Last time, 9:30 or 10, maybe. Speaking to Jalandhar devotee. He is going to take flight today. I am speaking, my boy, be careful. If you feel any attraction for woman, then you cannot do bhajan. In whole Punjab, I cannot find one single devotee with whom I can feel fit, who I can think totally dedicated. They are nice. So if you can respond to my, you know, order, then you can come out successful. Be careful, otherwise you cannot maintain your bhajan. So this way, as I was bound to speak, so illusion, maya. Those who are parinambit means consequent. Because in this material world, any object, always changing. Changing, na? Your body always changing, na? Metabolic system, all your body changing. You cannot understand. Continuously you are watching every day in mirror. But if you keep mirror away, if you look yourself after 10 years, then you can understand the change in your body. Follow what I say. So those who are actually elevated devotee, they always try to see the Jivatma, they are inside you. And at all if they see the body, they see this is the blood and flesh. If I get out blood and flesh, I can find some skeleton. Skeleton, you know? Skeleton. Calcium phosphate. Skeleton. Or bone structure. You cannot understand he or she, man and woman. If I give the structure, you know, bone structure, you know, skeleton only, total, you cannot know who is man. You have to think always, there is bone, there is some marrow, flesh and blood, or like, you know, our Guru Bhargava used to say, my son, always try to remember, when those who are going to meet some pratima, you know, deity, demigods, they are using straw first. They tie up straw, after they are putting, you know, mud, after they are giving shape and design, after that the final touch, dry up, then paint, then make Durga Devi or Kali or Ganesh. If you are really intelligent, always try to think that Maharaj, all matter, nothing else. Nothing else. All matter. You will have to spit. If the body is going to die, it can get decomposed. Decompose, you know? Spoil. Today, if you keep the body, you will have to stop your nose. There is a condition of this body. But still, people cannot understand. All around illusion. Jaya sanmita jivaha atmanam tigunatmakam. Atmanam tigunatmakam. Jayasan mahita jivaha atmanam tigunatmakam. Follow? They are always jiva, all jiva, countless jiva, not a matter of jo. Those jiva, countless jiva, infinity jiva, they are hypnotized by the maya. Illusion, illusory energy of maya, Supreme Lord. Nobody can understand. So, be careful when Sri Krishna speaking in Gita, Mama Maya Durataya. Nobody can cross my Maya. Quite impossible, next to impossible. Mama Maya Durataya. But only he who is totally inclined unto my lotus feet, only and only he can cross this material ocean Maya. Mamemo je prapadyante. Maya metam metam maya taranti te janaha je janaha they are showing submission unto my lotus feet 100%. Mama maya durattaya mameva ya prapadyante maya metam taranti te. And that day you are speaking that Bhagavan, it is a standing instruction of Sri Krishna Bhagavan. Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking that I am going to take your responsibility, total responsibility. I am going to take your total responsibility. What responsibility? Yogokhyama bahamyaham. Yogokhyama bahamyaham. I can take your responsibility, total responsibility. Yog and khem. That day I was speaking. This way, actually, it is quite impossible, next to impossible, for bonded soul to cross maya. Because Maya is also infinity. Maya, material Maya, aprakito yogamaya is endless. Mahamaya also endless. Because if we can understand that this is the picture, I mean shadow of that Maya, that is infinity, it is also infinity. Mahamaya duratta, that Maya is also infinity. Out of your own effort, you cannot come out successful. So this way, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, I can take your responsibility. Mami vijaya prapadante maya mitam tarantite. So for bonded soul, by now we understand there is one way open. If they are totally inclined unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord, I mean, unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava. Because directly you cannot get in. Directly you cannot go and show your submission unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. Directly you cannot show your submission unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. You have to show your submission through Guru Vaishnava. So, Jaya Sanmehita Jivaha, Jaya Sanmehita Jivaha. Atmanam trigunatmakam. They are covered up with maya. They cannot understand. So, what is the procedure? Now, we will have to take shelter unto a lotus feet of pure Guru Vaishnava. Many times I told you can remember, maya jaya, to get first that point, you remember what Prabhupada told? Whenever look at anything, whenever you look at anything, you will have to relate that object or that man or woman with, relate that object with Krishna. Follow. If you look at Vrinda Devi, you will have to think Vrinda Devi, Bhakti Devi. You cannot think, I can get some leap from this Vrinda Devi and chew, then I can, my cold can go away. With honey and some tulsi leaf, I can chew, I can rectify myself. This way I can follow. If you look at Vrinda Devi, you can think, this Vrinda Devi can give me bhakti. So anything you will look at, then you will have to relate each and everything with Krishna. So you can remember, Rajastamascha satyena sattancha upasamena cha etat sarvam guru bhakta purushohi anjasajayat. That maya, when Krishna speaking, it is quite impossible, but still that Krishna, speaking in Bhagavatam, it is very easy. Krishna speaking for bonded soul, it is quite impossible to get, you know, out of Maya. Whereas that Krishna speaking to Uddhava, Uddhava in Bhagavatam. In Gita, speaking, Mama Maya Durattaya. You cannot go out of Maya. Impossible. Those who are inclined to me, they can go out. And in Bhagavatam speaking, it's very easy. If you can go on thinking about how to go out of Maya whole life, then when you can start bhajan? If you are fighting whole life to get victory over Maya, whole life you are gone. Suppose you are going to live 8 years, now you are already 35, maybe 32. So if you 8 years minus 32, so if your whole life you are going to fight with this object, that I like to get out, go out of the influence of Maya, then when you can start bhajan? If you can go out of the influence of Maya, then and only then you can do bhajan. Bhajan is not possible. Within Maya you are, all the time you are doing, I can do bhajan. How you can do bhajan? Maya, not possible. So the procedure I already told, I cannot go in detail. Rajas tamasya satyena satyancha upasameena cha etat sarvam guru bhaktya purusha hi anjasaya het. Raja, tama and sata. Sata guna, rajaguna and tamaguna. These three modes of nature are going to put you in trouble. If you are going to take the help of Sataguna, that is also bondage. Sataguna also bondage. You have to go, cut three modes of nature and go to Shuddha Sata, pure Sata, Shuddha Sataguna. Then you can go out of the influence and you will have to serve Guru Vaishnava and Bhagavan from heart. If you cannot do, you cannot expect you can do bhajan. Pure sadhu, you will have to serve Sadguru Vaishnav. Etat sarvam guru bhakta. Guru means Sadguru. Realized soul. Not that ordinary guru. Krishna speaking, you will have to serve pure guru. Sadguru. Those who have connection with Supreme Lord all the time. So if you can serve, then very easily you can conquer Maya. Follow what I say. Now actually we are now going to understand the condition of bonded soul. And Vyasadeva Goswami what watching? I already told what? Vyasadeva Goswami watching Supreme Lord with his effulgence. Supreme Lord. First effulgence is and with all Shakti, Sarup and Shakti, total. By the mercy of Naraji Maharaj, he watching by now, he is watching Supreme Lord there. And backside Supreme Lord, he watching Maya Devi, Maya. Maya, you know, Maya? Illusory energy, Maya Devi, Durga. Bow down head, shrugging the head. Very shy, feeling shy. Mayadevi always feeling shy to come in front of Supreme Lord. So, bow down, backside Krishna, cannot come in front of Krishna. So, Vyasadeva Goswami watching everything. Everything. And all Jimatma, infinity, Jivas, they are not getting any solution of their life. Some of them in Tatastha condition, I translated that, you know, I forget to bring it. It's not, I bring this paper. I translated in library that Prabhupada writing one article, very nice. Baddha, Tatastha and Mukta. Three conditions of Jiva. So now I like to touch one very vital point, that is infinity Jiva. They are also vibhinamsha. Vibhinamsha, you know, you don't know. Those who are tattvabhi, they know. Vibhinyangsa and sangsa. Deeparchirebo, this sloka, you know. This sloka, there in Brahma Sangita we find that one main pradip, you know, candle, main. is there. Then, just a few days ago, I am coming back from Radhakund, there I find countless Pradeep, one man actually, devotee, they arrange thousands of, you know, Pradeep with ghee. All around, night time. Well, it seems, you know, very nice. Countless Pradeep they put in row with all already oil and so many people at a time. This place, they are step by step. They are taking the responsibility to enlighten all different. Diparchireva dasantaram abhipetta dipayate vibhritto hetu samana dharma. This sloka. Same. You cannot understand what candle is first candle. You cannot understand. Because so many devotees at a time. Because if you try to do yourself, if you want to, like, because by that time, oil can finish. So many devotees at a time they are putting. I was surprised to see and never see. So countless. In Radha Kunda, all step, you know. 1, 2, 3, 4, all step are countless. Each maybe 10 inch or 5, 6 inch difference. Countless Pradeep, Mat Pradeep. Oh, so nice beauty of Radha Kund. So you cannot buy, now you cannot understand which one is the original Pradeep. Which one is the original Pradeep? So from Krishna we find the first manifestation is Balaram, first expansion. Balaram is the first expansion of Krishna, Pratham Prakash Vigraha. And from Balaram, we find all Chaturbuha already. That Balaram there in Vrindavan playing with Krishna, that is the Mool, Sankarshan. And in, after that, you can find four Sankarsa Padunya Anuddha Sankarshan. You see, Chaturbuha, Pradunno, Aniruddha, Vasudev, Sankarshan, four, there. And from there again, four, down in Vaikuntha, in Golokdham, in between Setadip, inside that Vrindavan Dham, like lotus flower, the core is Vrindavan, just little outside, is all around. It is Vrindavan. Just around this one, around, there is called Navadip, Shetadip. After that, the petals you can find one by one. So there, gradually we can see countless incarnation of Supreme Lord coming. You cannot count. Countless incarnation of Supreme Lord in countless Brahmanda. Infinity Brahmanda, infinity incarnations, you cannot count. It is written in Bhagavad, if you are mad enough to count the dust particle of this earth, still I cannot say you are mad. Follow what I mean to say, try to realize my heart. If you are mad enough to count the dust particle of this, okay, still I cannot say you are mad, crazy. But still, if you want to count the incarnation of Supreme Lord, you are double crazy. Follow. This way you are going to take the risk. Impossible. Not possible. So now you think, those incarnation coming from Supreme Lord, all from where? In each Brahmanda from, ultimately all, you know, Karuna Namasai, from there all. After that, Garbhodaya Gosai, from Garbhodaya Gosai, from each Garbhodaya Gosai Vishnu, in each Brahmanda, all aparadha kind. Follow. Garbhodaya Gosai, you don't know. Karuna Namasai is the original cause, not Krishna is the original cause, but for this reason I am speaking, that he is the cause of all Brahmanda, infinity Brahmanda. Follow. Though everything coming from Krishna, but still, infinity Brahmanda coming from Mahavishnu. That sloka I often speak. yasaika nisheshito kalam athavalambo jivanti loma bhilaja jagadandanatha vishnur mahanasa iho yasso kalavishesho gavindam adi purusham tamaham bhajami. This slok. So, infinity brahmanda express, each hair tips there, hair tips, each having each in each hair tip the infinity brahmanda. Now you cannot guess, you can go mad. There is no sufficient tattva there in Quran, there is no sufficient tattva in Bible, nothing. You cannot get. All you can get scientific document from Bhagavatam everywhere. Okay. So you see, infinity brahmanda coming from Mahavishnu, Mahavishnu. Now you think. And each brahmanda, in each brahmanda, in each brahmanda, infinity brahmanda coming out. But each brahmanda, there is one that Mahavishnu entering into each brahmanda in the form of Garbhodaka Sai Vishnu. That is the Garbhodaka Sai Vishnu where Brahma or all demigods going to pray unto the lotus feet of Kshirodaka Sai, not Garbhodaka Sai. From that Garbhodaka Sai, from that Garbhodaka Sai, each world, prithivi, there one Kshirodaka Sai Vishnu, who is resting into the heart of all Jivatma, into the heart as Paramatma. Don't understand. Garbhodaka Sai there in each Brahmanda, from that Garbhodaka Sai, each Brahmanda, Garbhodaka Sai, from there Garbhodaka Sai is coming and slipping into the ocean of Kshirodaka Sai, milk ocean, in this earth. There is milk ocean. I can speak after. They are speaking, you cannot understand. They are all, if any problem happens with demigods, the demigods and demons are fighting, then after that, the demigods together with Brahma and Sangha, they are approaching Kshirodaka Sai Vishnu, Khir Sagar, to pray. And that Kshirodaka Sai Vishnu is Aniruddha Vishnu, he is staying inside the heart of all Jivatma as Paramatma. Follow. Inside your heart, her heart, me, everybody, all Jivatma, even mosquito, all heart. Staying in the form of Paramatma, Kshirodaka Sai Vishnu. He is the root cause of all, you know, staying inside. Follow. Now point is that, those countless Jivatma, they are not getting any solution. Or not only Prabhupada writing, I can give the documents from Shamananda Parivar, topmost Pandit in Baladev Vidyavasan Parivar, ultimately. His name is actually as Vishambarananda Dev Goswami. Prabhupada speaking that I have never seen in my life, whole life I am running from South Indian seashore up to Himalaya. I never meet with such a, powerful personality who is having full knowledge about Satasandarbha. Prabhupada passing him. I am very satisfied with that devotee. His name is Vishambarananda Geshwar. So he also putting same document like Prabhupada. I already told his name, na? When, Brahman Vaishnava fighting going on in Balighai, that time he was the president. And he requesting Prabhupada, Madhusudan Saraswati Pad there from Vrindavan came. Madhusudan. They request Prabhupada, Vimalapasana Saraswati, you will have to find solution of Brahman Vaishnava fighting. Prabhupada. That's when he was the chairperson. Very nice. He also speaking. And Prabhupada also writing one small article. I already translated. We don't put in internet as yet. We'll have to edit it. Okay. So, Baddha, Tatastha and Mukta. Three conditions of Jivas. Bonded in Chaitanya Charitamrita, It is written, usually in this material world, you can find two types of jiva. You cannot understand who is Tatastha, where is Tatastha. Tatastha jiva, you cannot see. Don't follow what I mean to say. Baddha and Mukta jiva, you can see. See mean? At least you can see Mukta jiva and Baddha jiva here. But Tatastha jiva, you cannot find. But Tatastha jiva, if Jivatma is going to take one body, material body, then and only then he can see. But Atma can never be seen. Atma can never be seen. And there is countless Atma. Countless, like dust particle is also not so, you know, perfect. Like dust particle, you know, one light beam from sun coming, entering into room. If you watch, you can find in the ray, suspended, you know, countless dust particle, no? One light beam of sunlight coming and try. And from darkness, if you watch, then you can see countless dust particle there. More than that, Jivatma, there all around, but you cannot see. You cannot see. That is the in Bhagavata Sura, Bhagavatam, we find, Atma avasyam idam sarvam yat kinchit jagadam jagat. Atma avasya means it's all covered up with Atma, countless. You cannot see. When those Atma are going to take one material body, only and only, oh, it is tiger, oh, it is lion, oh, it is a snake. Follow. If Atma is there, everywhere you cannot see. Nayam Atma pravachanena labhyo no medhaya no bahuna surteno. You have heard so many scriptural analysis, you have gone through so many scriptural analysis, you have, you know, you have your power, but still cannot come out successful. Naya no ayam atma pravachanena labhyo no medhaya. Your brain is very sharp, still you cannot come out successful. So only and only when that Paramatma is going to accept you, okay, I am going to accept him. In that case, you can understand. When Paramatma is going to accept you, okay, I can accept you. In that case, you can understand. Now, in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Mahaprabhu, when giving Sanatana Sikha, there you can get nice explanation by Sivan Mahaprabhu. Sei to jiva hoy baddho and mukto. Nitya baddho, nitya mukto. Nitya mukto, those who are nitya mukto and nitya baddho, you will have to understand clearly. Otherwise, whole life you can understand Bhagavad Tattva. So, let me explain. Dipar chireva, this sloka I already explained. So, by this I wanted to explain, if from Vishnu Tattva, another Vishnu Tattva coming, their light, you know, same. Follow? Same light. So Vishnu Tattva, because in Aprakita Jagat, transcendental world, we know that from Purna Vastu, Purna, you know, complete, perfect, absolute. From absolute, if you want to get out absolute, then absolute residue. Follow my point. In this material world, if there is 5 liter milk, in this material, suppose there is 5 liter milk with you, I want to get 1 liter, then from 5 liter you are going to give me 1 liter, then the residue is 5 minus 1 liter. Follow what I say? Then a 5 minus 1 liter is 4 liter at present you have. This is the usual thing. Follow what I say. But that is not the case in the transcendental world. Suppose this is Purna Vastu, Govardhan coming. I take Govardhan from Golok Vrindavan, here is Govardhan. But still Govardhan is there. You cannot understand, you cannot make any head and tail. You can go mad. How possible, Maharaj? Because always you want to play your material brain and conception. Whereas many times I told Popa as well, logical interpretation cannot stand logical interpretation cannot stand in the way of that absolute truth. Many times I told, it is the version of Prabhupada. Prabhupada used to speak. Logical interpretation cannot stand in the way of that absolute truth. So from Upanishad we find, Purnasya Purna Madayo Purna Meva Avashishvate. If from Purna Vastu, if I want to get Purna, then Purna is residue. But you cannot tally, you cannot understand, you cannot understand any head and tail. What is it? From Purna Vastu, if Purna coming out, that's still Purna. So Vishnu Tattva, from Vishnu Tattva, countless avatar can come. Ram, Nishinga, Varaha, you know, countless avatar can come. Juga avatar, Leela avatar, Mannantar avatar, different kind of, I can discuss this point someday. Shaktavish avatar, all different kind of avatar. You will have to digest, foolish. Eh? You have to speak Harikatha. After my death, or even now you can also speak. Practice. I have to speak and do acharan should be there. So you see, there it is written that all countless avatar, different kind of avatars there. So different kind of Purusha avatar there, then Saktavesh avatar, Mannantara avatar, different kind of avatar. Oh, countless. But still, if we say that Ramchandra is more, Nishingadev is more powerful than Kurmadev, we should not speak that way. We should not speak. Only there is some diversity, only there is some diversity of Leela. Kurmadev, Vishnu Tattva, Kurmadev playing that way, Nishingadev playing that way, Barahodev playing that way. So you cannot make any distinction. Oh, he is more or less powerful. No, don't speak that way. All Vishnu Tattva, Deepar Chirepa Dasantaram Bhavvetta Deepayate Vibhritta Hetu Samana Dharma Jastadrik Eva Vishnuttaya Vivati Govindamadi Purusham Tamaham Bhajami. This sloka. So all, they are all Vishnu Tattva. Don't try to make any distinction, don't try to make any, Why? Because though Vishnu Tattva, but there is one speciality, that each Vishnu Tattva having some speciality. Nishingadev coming and showing some Leela, speciality of Leela. Ramchandra coming and showing some speciality of Leela. Nishingadev and Ram all paravarastha, topmost condition. Okay, regarding Leela. Krishna is actually root cause. All root cause actually. Krishna is the true. Govinda Madhi Purusham Tamam Bhajami. Krishna is the Sisti Siti Palaya Sadhana Sakti Reka Chayeva Jasovanani Vivurti Durga Ichchanu Rupamapi Chesta Tesa Govinda Madhi Purusham Tamam Bhajami. This way. So now Svamsha Tattva mean all coming from Krishna ultimately. All coming from Krishna, na? Ultimately coming from Krishna. So we see Ananta Brahmanda coming from Mahavishnu, Mahavishnu coming from Krishna. Okay. Now the point is that all countless Vishnu avatar, they are all Svamsha Tattva. Follow. They are all Svamsha. Svamsha Tattva means all coming from Krishna. They are almost equal to Krishna. Why you speak almost? Because some speciality there is Krishna. That's why I'm putting this word. Almost same. All Vishnu Tattva. Don't try to make any discrimination. There is aparad. Vishnu Tattva all same. Follow what I say? In Chaitanya Bhagavad, this Siddhanta is clearly written. In Chaitanya Bhagavad, Vrindavan Das Thakur Mahasaya is the Vyasadeva of Chaitanya Leela. There it is written that Chaitanya, that Vrindavan Das Thakur writing that when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Vishnu Priya marriage ceremony going on, then some outside people look Lakshmi Narayan. Somebody speaking, no, Ram Sita, so beautiful consort, divine consort. They cannot understand, he is Supreme Lord. At least they can understand by the help of Yogamaya. Aprakita. Somebody says, no, is this. But actually, Vrindavan Das Thakur Mahasaya, whatever people speaking, Vrindavan Das Thakur writing this Siddhanta, what, maybe what, because they have different kind of view, darshan. So whatever they are going to speak, different kind of mood they are expressing, but anyway, whatever people speaking, all let them speak, all perfect. Vrindavan Thakur, whatever they are speaking, all perfect. Because He is Supreme Lord, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Krishna, Chaitanya, Krishna Himself. So inside Krishna, all Vaman Devi is there. Inside Krishna, Ram is there. Huh? Everything there? So what wrong? Let them speak. All right. Keho bale, somebody is speaking Ram Sita, somebody is saying, no, Lakshmi Narayan. Okay, all perfect. They are not speaking wrong. Because He is Supreme Lord. Supreme Lord mean? By to me? What? The original root cause, Krishna. Swayamrup Bhagavan. You must remember this term. If you forget, you cannot speak. Krishna and Krishna Chaitanya, both they are Swayamrup Bhagavan. Swayamrup Bhagavan, why? They need not depend upon anybody. They are Swayamrup Bhagavan, why? They are Supreme Lord, only Supreme. Narayan also Supreme Lord. Narayan also Supreme Lord. Ram also Supreme Lord. But what is the speciality? Swayamrup Bhagavan means all everything coming from Him. He need not depend upon anybody. In Bhagavatam, that sloka, Yanma Dasu Yatu Anvayadi Twarashvarta Savigya Sarat. This Savigya and Sarat are the total factors staying with Krishna. Even Balaram, Krishna make fool of Balaram. Because Krishna is having willpower, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing. Krishna is total willpower with Krishna. What Krishna want, that will happen. Balaram will have to obey that. And sometime Krishna going to obey Balaram, that is prema. That is different thing. That is out of prema. Krishna going to massage the leg of Balaram. I already told, na? Krishna massaging the leg of elder brother Balaram. Don't think that Balaram going to take seva from Krishna. Follow. Are Maharaj, I was that Krishna going to massage the lotus feet of Krishna. Balaram, okay, maybe you can see, but it is actual the seva of Krishna. How? Well, Balaram allowing Krishna to serve lotus feet of Himself simply because Krishna becomes satisfied. Krishna gets satisfaction. Let me massage your leg. I can be okay. Follow. It is the case with Ramanujacharya. One devotee, one sevak of Ramanujacharya. All devotees speaking, Gurudev, He is making your bed. Okay. After making your bed, He is sleeping on the bed. And then get up and invite you to sleep. Hey, you are sleeping in my bed? All devotees speaking, yes, Gurudev. Why? I am sleeping so that if there is any problem in the bed, that's why I am testing, you can get comfort or not. That's why I was just testing. So, prema, topmost prema, you cannot understand with the material brain. Jagadananda Pandit inside Gambhira, not Jagadananda, actually Govinda. Govinda, the sevak, is called second Sachima, taking care of Gauranga, Prabhu, all the time, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And one day Mahaprabhu sleeping, after taking prasadam, coming inside Gambhira. You've been there in Gambhira temple, very small apartment, very small, in Puri, Gambhira, Kasimishra Bhavan. There Mahaprabhu sleeping, Mahaprabhu, Lord, tall figure. Mahaprabhu, Govinda coming, Prabhu, you will have to give sight so that I can enter into room and massage your leg. Prabhu is thinking, I have no power to move my body. You want to come or don't want to get, that's up to you. Mahaprabhu, very clever. Mahaprabhu sleeping and the door is blocked. The room is very small. Govinda, Prabhu, please, try to give me space, so that passage, so that I can enter into room. You are sleeping, how he can cross you? Prabhupada speaking, I cannot move my body, I am too tired today. Mahaprabhu tired. Supreme Lord tired. No, I am too tired today, I cannot move. You want to come or you don't want, that's up to you. Then Govinda what doing? Govinda putting his own cloth on Mahaprabhu's body and cross Mahaprabhu, crossing. Whereas he is prohibited to cross the shadow of Binda Devi and Vaishnava. He is crossing Mahaprabhu, Sakshat, Swayambhu Bhagavan, Krishna Chaitanya, and going inside and messaging the lady. After messaging for some time and speaking, you know, after that, Govinda sitting. Because Mahaprabhu sleeping, not going outside. After some time, a little bit, Mahaprabhu taking rest for half an hour. Mahaprabhu sleeping half an hour. 40 minutes maximum. After that, Govinda, you not gone? Where? To take prasadam? How I can go? You are sleeping here? How you came inside? How you came inside? That way you should go and take prasadam? Well, that time I came inside to do your seva. And now I am going to take prasadam is my self-interest. So I cannot go now. You see the prema, siddhanta. Is it written in Chaitanya Bhagavat? This siddhanta I am speaking. Krishna going to message Balaram, but it's the seva of Krishna. Balaram not going, you know, seva of Krishna. Krishna want to get satisfied after messaging the latest tweet of Balaram. There is a secrecy of Siddhanta. So, what do you mean by devotion? Devotion, if you are at all going to serve on Guru Vaishnav, you will have to seek the total satisfaction of Guru Vaishnav, right? What do you mean by seva? What do you mean by seva? If you want to serve your Gurudev, oh, I can do serve. Foolish. Gurudev, if Gurudev is satisfied, you will have to follow that way. You cannot follow a fanciful way. Oh, I can serve this way. No. This way you will have to give. Seva mean, you will have to seek the total satisfaction of Guru, Vaishnava or Bhagavan. Not your satisfaction. So many times, some people wanted to give donation to Prabhupada. Prabhupada, you must arrange one big bandara, feast. Prabhupada say, you take away your money. Many people, very top secret Siddhanta. Many times, many rich people with some money coming and paying this money to Prabhupada. Prabhupada, you take this money. What I can do with this money? You can arrange one big bandara. Bandara mean, you know, feast, big feast. You take away your money. I cannot take. Why? You are giving this money to me. It is my responsibility to seek your good. I can do bandara, I can print books, that's up to me. Why you are putting instruction to me? Take away your money, I am less interested about me. Take away. Follow this Siddhanta. You are giving donation to me, you should be 100% sure that Maharaj taking this donation, he is going to do perfect seva. Maharaj not going to take, or Maharaj has no bank, nothing. 100% you, if you are going to give me instruction, Maharaj, this money I am giving, you can arrange bandara. You do your bandara. Why you are giving instruction to me? If you believe me, then you be sure that I am going to utilize this money for you, the best possible way I can try to seek your satisfaction, seek your good. So you must trust on me. So this way actually, all those, you know, Vishnu avatar, Sri Krishna Bhagavan and Sri Krishna Chaitanya, both Swayamrupa Bhagavan, root cause. All Adar, Balaram and all Ram, Nishinga, Varaha, all Purushavatar, all actually like Vishnu. Vishnu Tattva all same. Dipar Chireva, this sloka you already hear, all same. Vishnu Tattva, you should not make any discrimination. All Vishnu Tattva, all same, but still, some speciality of Leela is there. That's why we want to do the bhajan of Krishna. We can get. That's why even the name of Krishna and Ram, Sahasra Namnam Tirabhitta Tuyat Phalam, Sahasra Ram, Namna, Vishnu Nam, if you speak, you know, many times. Sahasranam nam tirabhita, three times, Sahasranam, Vishnunam, one Ramnam. And you are speaking Ramnam thousand, then it is equal to Krishnanam. Why? Regarding the exposure of my kripa. Don't think it is discrimination there. No. Vishnu Sahasranam you are reading three times is equal to one Ramnam. Don't think there is discrimination, Maharaj. No discrimination. Is the expression of Karuna, mercy. Ramnam is more merciful than Vishnu, Vishnunam. Krishnanam is more merciful than Ramnam. You cannot calculate, you cannot understand. You say, Maharaj, you already told that there should not be any discrimination. We find discrimination. No, no discrimination. Is the expression of Karuna. Even if I speak Krishna, Krishna, if you see, Ho Krishna Chaitanya, Ho Gaur, I am doing more than that Krishnanam. Gaurnam is more than Krishnanam. Why? In Gaurnam, more and more Karuna is, more and more Karuna. Those who are fallen, ears useless, go say, okay, okay, let them come to me. But Krishna cannot speak. But in Bhagavatam written there, without Krishna, what avatar was there who is going to give prema to creeper and trees? Creeper, you know? Lata. Who? Krishna is so marvelous. But still, in this Kalikal, after Krishna gone, Gauranga coming, more and more powerful. What to speak about the mercy of Gauranga? Patra patro vicharanam na kurute na sa param vikshate deya deyava vimarsakaha. This sloka, you will have to think. Patra patro vicharanam na kurute na sa param vikshate deya deyava vimarsakaha na hi na va kala pratiksha prabhu. With darshan, not doing bhajan. You see, come on, only darshan. One Muslim messenger came to help Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to cross Pichalda. That Muslim people, a go faint. When Mahaprabhu crossed the river, he started crying and fall down on ground. Oh, Prabhu, you gone. I cannot live without you. And Pratap Rudra, all wives, they are sitting on elephant back from long. They are watching. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going. And all they watching from elephant back. They are feeling some ecstatic feeling. What is this? The magic spell with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Or Chaitanya Gauranga Mahaprabhu, Abhirbhav coming, Gaur Purnim. I can go on discussing all this six matter. You can. So nice. So Gaurnam is, I would say, Gaurnam is more merciful than Krishnanam. Is it na? In Chaitanya Charitamrita? Krishnanam kare aparadher vichar. Krishnanam not going to touch your leg because you have done aparad. Krishnanam kare aparadher vichar. If you are doing aparad, Krishnanam cannot. You can speak Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. That is material Krishnanam. Transcendent, not aprakita Krishnanam. Aprakita Krishnanam means the word I am speaking, Krishna. With his word, Krishna himself present. Then it is the object. Bolo. It's called aprakita Krishnanam. And bonded soul, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. With this Krishnanam, Krishna is not present. They are practicing. Practicing just. Sometime namabhas, sometime namaparat. I can discuss this point. So there is no question of liberty or bondage soul. So this way, you see all, you know, their Svamsha avatar and vibhinamsha, all their countless jivatma there in this world, infinity universe, infinity jivatma. They are rolling and rolling in this life. You have taken birth in Brazil. Maybe this part you have taken birth in German. Maybe this birth this birth, you have taken birth in Italy, not. But Atma can do. Not that you are from Germany, you cannot come outside, it's not that. Because it's the usual property, natural property of a Jivatma to show devotion and tolerance. So it matters little from which country you are. Somebody can discourage you. Hey, you are from. No! It is the Atma is the same. Body, oh, why you are care your body? So you go on bhajan, then. So all Sangsa avatar and all infinity Jivatma, they actually vibhinamsha. Even Brahma, vibhinamsha jiva, but jiva koti. I can discuss this very secret point. When hundreds of births, one Jivatma going to follow Varnasam Dharma perfectly, hundreds of births, follow what he say, consecutively, one after another, each birth, he is taking birth and following Varnasam Dharma perfectly, to the point, no mistake. Then after hundreds of births, he can be given the chance to become Brahma. If any time when in this creation, then Krishna not going to find out such a suitable Jivatma who is just fit to be given this Brahma designation, this seat, then Krishna himself take the form of Hiranyagarbha. Hiranyagarbha Brahma. I mean Krishna himself become Brahma. What to do? No Jivatma there in Brahmanda. That Hiranyagarbha Brahma is Krishna himself, Vishnu. That is not Jivatma. All other Brahma and Sankat Tattva is more complicated. Somehow you have to discuss from Jiva Tattva angle, from Sangsa Tattva. Very typical. Shivaratri, Adi, etc. coming. Sanatana Gosai giving instruction, you will have to follow Shivaratri. Shivaratri doesn't mean that you are violating Krishna. Those who are going to obey Vishnu, and in Shiv Tattva, they understand that Shiv is Sadashiv, Vishnu Tattva. Foolish. Otherwise, you are going to worship Shivji with separate idea. It's a big bondage for you. Follow what I say. Great man, be careful. Don't try to worship Shankar in separate idea. You must seek. What? Shakshad Haritena Samasya Sastai. Ruktastata bhavati besadvi kintu pavarja piya vatasya. This way. I love Shankar from my boy, small boy. I wanted to get some material thing. Shankar don't give me. I am bound to speak. You can laugh. I wanted to get some material thing. Because now I cannot understand who am I. I wanted to go fast and do. And Shankar begins, you love Chaitanya and Krishna, you come to me, how I can cheat you? Krishna not giving this material thing. Guide me properly. Follow. So you don't try to expect anything material from Guru Vaishnav. And at the same time, Advaita Gosai, Abhirbhav Chichi coming, you can know. Mahavishnu Jagat Karta Mayayaja Sriyati Adaha Tasa Avatara Evayam Advaita Acharya Swaraha. I can discuss this point. Today I am going to stop, I am making background to prove that Jivatma Sarup is fixed or not. All different angles, different problems, what Jiva's position of Jivatma, what, you know, now I am making background. Final conclusion I can draw. But is this papers I can't bring, but I forget that. Because I was in a hurry, I take all paper, put inside bag. Anyway, Vancha Kalpa Durvasya ki Pasindhva. So any question if you have, and you must follow Tarun Krishna, all of you should have a nice relation with each other to grow devotional cult. Each and everybody should learn. If I find, then I can crush your head, or everybody's head, those who are doing. Mutual love, always. This is the speciality with great Vaishnava. I was wondering, I wanted to think, why people coming in front of Guru Maharaj, they become very happy. I was very surprised to watch. Why all people coming in front of Guru Maharaj become very happy? Why people not happy with me? I started thinking. Then I clue, I got answer, oh, this is the reason. Why people coming in from the Bhakti, Vaibha, Puri Maharaj, they become very happy? After darshan. That is the secret reason. That they have Pinanam Sarva Jagatam, I can explain. If you look one pure Vaishnava, you can get satisfied. Why? You cannot explain. Because pure devotion is there, Krishna is there. That's the only reason. Each and every family member, actually whole world, not Italy, France, America, Switzerland, not that. All whole world is one family, Gauri family, I think so. Only self-interest and divisive attitude making them fighting with each other. They're fighting with each other. Why fighting? Why fighting? They are fighting. There should not be any self-interest. Wow, whole world is one family. Follow? You are my son, she is my daughter, he is my son. Oh, this should be this idea. Otherwise, never you can do Krishna bhajan. Gauranga. Okay.